Welcome to Rick's Corner, brought to you by Old School Labs, the brand I trust and the only one I put my name to. Use my code Drayson12 on the link below.
Rick's Corner, the man, the myth, the legend. Now on with the show.
Fucking middle, look at that arm on you.
What? Dude, that's a fucking, you just, put that fucking arm's great. Just fucking, look. You've been through some fucking battles, kid.
That's all right, I'm still sexy.
That's what Sonny says.
Scruff going here, it looks good.
Yeah, look, me too. That's what Sonny says.
She loves me.
She says, you know Rick Drayson? I go, who fucking does? I go, if you've been in L.A. and you don't know Rick Drayson, you really haven't done any work, right? And she was laughing.
Yeah.
And I go, yeah, everybody knows Mariano, fucking Rick Drayson. And she was laughing, and she said, yeah, I love him, maybe a little too much.
Oh, what do? You have charm, that's the way it is. That's how it was in high school with me. My mom used to laugh at me. Y'all got all these girls chasing you when I was playing in the band. Mom, I don't
know. Oh, so you play music too?
I'm a guitarist.
No fucking shit.
Yeah, I had to deal with Capitol Records in the 60s.
You did?
I played Gazzari's, the Hollywood Bowl, in Vegas, yeah.
I was a bouncer there for a while.
Yeah, well, I bounced in and played and left.
Yeah, you did the whole job, huh?
Yeah. Something in my tooth.
I played music for a minute.
I like it. I still play.
I'm a drummer.
I like good music. I mean, I like Chet Atkins and guys that finger picking guitars and all that. It's not easy, but I enjoy playing.
Them fingers, though, you look like a bass player because they're thick. We can track.
I wear a big ring size.
I know, man. Look at your fucking mitts on you.
Yeah.
I was never a big guy. I was always like,
Doesn't mean I'm a bad person.
I told, you know, Shark, right?
Yeah.
Crazy Shark. I told Shark, I said, Shark, yeah, I'm going to do a show with Rick. And he goes, oh, I love Rick. He's a great kisser.
He would say that.
That fucking kid's nuts, ain't he?
Yeah,
you know, he was a corner man for Nico Hill.
But he's funny.
One of the guys I'm inducting. Do you know Nico?
I met him on the phone through Patricia.
Yeah, Nico.
She hears him over the phone.
He's a tough motherfucker.
I know he is.
One of the toughest guys ever in the world.
He was like really nice to me.
Oh, he's a sweetheart. You know, he's an evangelist and a preacher now.
Mm-hmm.
One of my best buddies.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I invited the sensei, too. Did you ever go to the Oyster Bar? Remember Christopher?
I know the Oyster Bar.
Yeah, Christopher was a bartender there for like 30 years. And they closed, but that's his sensei.
They're still open, aren't they?
No, they closed down.
Oh, I didn't know that. All right, I'm ready to start this. The camera's rolling.
Okay, hold on one second. Can I piss real quick?
Why didn't you tell me this before you came in?
Because I piss every 10 minutes.
Go, in the hallway, there's a bathroom. Oh, Kevin, you got issues. You have to turn the water on so you can pee?
Yeah, you notice that?
Oh my god.
I'm fucked up, bro. I got fucking
like a 5-year-old child.
you know
Daddy,
what?
Can you turn the water on so I go pee pee?
You know what it is? It's just the fucking process. Everything.
You're
wrecked. Everything's fucking wrecked in me. I mean, I look good walking down the street, but if you take a fucking x-ray of me, I'm smoking like you.
If you have sex with a girl, she's going to sue you for assault with a dead weapon.
With intent to swell.
All right, here we go. All right, welcome to Rick's Corner. I have a very good friend of mine, Kevin Copeland, also known as Indio, who I've known for a great many years. We've done some stuff together on film, and he's very much into fighting the martial arts, bare-knuckle fights. You name it, he does it, and he's just a really super guy. And what's really funny is we've been friends for so long, we don't see each other for long periods of time, but it always comes back around where when we do see each other, it's like we just saw each other yesterday. You know what I mean?
Well, it just was.
There's no time lost in between.
Right.
And that only happens to a few people in life, because otherwise you kind of lose touch, and you don't know what to say anymore, you know? So tell me a little bit about your history, about where you began. I know you worked out and you did some fighting. What started all that?
I came out here. I was a fighter in the ring at first,
mm-hmm.
the first Kumite, through tournaments.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did some Golden Gloves,
mm-hmm.
did some boxing, then AAU boxing, and on to had a couple kickboxing matches. Wasn't into it, went in the underground, got into bare knuckle, and came out here. And my very first stunt job, you gave me like 50 years ago.
I actually did.
Like 150 million years ago.
Yeah. That was a fun time, though. We had 3 days on it.
You know, I forgot about it. Like I was talking to the other day, and I just remembered Mini Me.
Mm-hmm.
I remember
we did a music video with Method Man and Red Man. It was filmed at the Barker Hangar at Santa Monica Airport, and they asked me how to do this. The producer, well, how do I do this? I said, well, you get a ring, you bring it in, number one, because it's a wrestling skit. Then you're going to bring in about 100 or more extras and put them all around the ring like you would do a TV match. And then you want to hang about 40-foot black curtains all the way around to make the arena dark. And then add a smoke machine and overhead lights. Because you need the ambience. And you just can't go into a building with lights on in a ring and say, okay, there it is. Because you got to have that ambience of the dark behind. You don't know what's back there. But the smoke covers most of it. And you have... It looked like a real arena. Didn't it?
I thought it was.
Yeah.
You know, when I went in, it had the ambience of a real arena.
That was my job, was to coordinate that, coordinate the wrestling, and put the whole thing together, and I did. And they're pretty nice to me, actually. So you were there, and a bunch of people that we knew. And they,
Mini-Me, Red Man, Method Man.
We made Mini-Me, and we made him the referee. So these big guys are running around the ring, and here's Mini-Me going like this, and I hope they don't kick me like a football out of the ring. Oh my God, that was so funny. I thought he'd be great for that part. And he did. I mean, he was okay.
Did you cast him for that?
Yeah.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh, so you did the casting and stuff
for
that too?
Yeah, it's like a short job.
Yeah, I was actually an extra and you pulled me out.
I did.
You said, hey, I heard you're a fighter and you pulled me out. That was it. That's when
you had on a pimp outfit.
Yeah. Yeah, I had the, well, you told me, you said, I want you to be Freddie Blassie. Do you
know right. The manager.
I go. Of course, I know. You know, classy Freddie Blassie. So I was like, and I had long hair. Remember the ponytail?
I do. Yeah.
And then the other bodybuilder was in it.
There's a few of them. Well, Aaron Baker.
Aaron Baker.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was successful, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mr. America or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We had some good guys there. That's for sure. And remember, the Method Man Red Man wouldn't come out of their trailer to work. They just sat there and smoked dope all day long. So we just hung out until they'd come out and do a scene. They'd go back in their trailer and sit down again. But those were the days of that kind of stuff.
They were wrestling too. Remember that?
Yeah.
And then that video made it. That video was in an LL Cool J movie. You know the song, "Turn It Up."
Mm-hmm.
You know the movie "Turn It Up"
mm-hmm.
with LL Cool J. So that video was that movie's video.
Is that video on YouTube?
Yes, sir.
I have never found it.
We should repost it. I'll find it for you.
Yeah, let's do that. They wanted me to wrestle too, but I was so busy coordinating and doing stuff. I had my stuff on, but I never got in a ring once.
Yeah.
So I didn't have to, which is okay with me. I might get hurt.
We should, you know, did a tag team.
Well, you're working with actors that don't know how to wrestle. You're going to get hurt.
Well, you did teach. Was it Method Man? Yeah, mm-hmm. He wrestled.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you showed him some moves. He did some wrestling.
I did, but let me put it this way. When you get into the ring to wrestle, you got to know how wrestling works. You got to work loose, you got to sell, and you got to make it look right, even though it's brutal. But you get in there with an actor who doesn't know, they're going to stiff you every time and really hurt you because they don't know how not to.
I don't know what it is when you work with actors and you do a stunt.
Mm-hmm.
They always get hit. You go, okay, when I throw here, you move left, and they always move the wrong way.
I had to do a tug-of-war with an actor on camera, and the tug-of-war is like, pull, you know, and I mean, you're not really pulling, you're just pulling. This guy's trying to pull me off my feet and make me sick. Do you know how to act? You know, you're supposed to simulate what we're doing.
They try to make it too real, and they go overboard.
Yeah.
They overact.
Yeah.
Most overact.
So after that, then you've been doing some film work?
Yeah. Did some film work. I did a slew of film work, and you know, a couple karate movies.
Mm-hmm.
I did the Circuit 2 and 3, which I think every B actor in Hollywood was on it, but you.
Yeah.
And then onto a bunch of stuff, a bunch of film, TV, like you. You know, had a good illustrious career, and
you know, there were times when you could work all the time. Nowadays, it's like not the same.
Yeah, you used to go from one job to the next, remember?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Guys were dying in crashes because they're working 12 hours, mm-hmm. working golden time, and then they'd be booked the next day, and you just sleep in your car.
Different deal today. I don't even go on auditions anymore. I got tired of it. I'm not driving to Santa Monica at 4 o'clock on a Friday.
You get stuck. And I'll tell you what, the newest thing is that a lot of actors don't like. Now it's all self-tape. Yes. You have to actually tape yourself.
Well, like this here, I could do an audition tape right here and send it in, and they could watch it. And if you don't come across the way they want you, you're done. It doesn't work.
Yeah, what I did is I go to a service. You pay $30, and it's a teleprompter, everything. You look like you memorized all your lines.
Really?
And a teleprompter, yeah. Yep,
That's pretty cool.
Goes right across. Yeah, yeah. They're called, it's called Auditions on the Fly.
I didn't know they
Auditions
had that.
On the Fly, yeah. It's right in Valley Village.
I didn't know they had that.
It's convenient and great. I go there, park, walk in. The dude has a little setup in his apartment. You film it, and then he forwards it to you and your manager or agent, send it in.
That's a good business.
You might want to do that.
I might want to.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I might.
We might be doing it right now.
And so after that, I mean, you were doing films. What you're doing now? You're doing some stuff now.
Yeah, so at the end of it, I'm an ex-fighter. I was acting, and, you know, everything's going okay, and it's good. And I said, you know what? How can I, make a legacy? You know, because I have a daughter. I go, what would she really be proud of? Okay, I did some acting. I did some fighting. I go, what could I make a legacy and at the same time help people? So I have two friends, and both of them said, don't say I gave you the idea. But one of them whispered in my ear, and he said, bare-knuckle fighter. And then the other one whispered in my other ear, bodyguard.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm both. I was a bare-knuckle fighter,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, I'm still an active bodyguard.
Mm-hmm.
And I just came up with a Hall of Fame. And then the Hall of Fame, I showed the idea to a couple people. And then I was funded. And now we have a Hall of Fame, and we're having our first event at the Martial Arts History Museum,
right,
in Burbank.
On Magnolia Boulevard. I'm going to put your poster up.
On Magnolia, and you'll be there.
I'll be there.
Of course.
Kane and all.
We got everybody. Kimbo Slice will be being honored by his dad. He'll be receiving an award. Nico the Dragon Hill. Luke Mad Dog Massey. I mean, these names are great, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Don't you love the names?
Yep.
They're like wrestling names.
Yep.
And then we got three bodyguards, and we were even inducting a female.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, yeah, a female bodyguard.
That wouldn't be me, would it?
No, you've been.
This is going to be fun. So this is your first time to promote this?
Yeah, this is the first time. So now we have a Hall of Fame, and Cheyenne, one of the fighters, he actually, unfortunately, is deceased, but his family's flying out from Florida to accept an award for him.
That's really nice.
So yeah, it's going to be really nice. I just hope I don't cry on stage.
You can cry on stage all you want. There's nothing wrong with that. It doesn't mean you're less of a man. This is the Martial Arts Museum on Magnolia, which is like a really cool place.
It's a really cool place. Yeah, I was. They have their own. They have their own Hall of Fame, which
right.
has legends like Jerry Okamura and James Liu.
Yep.
And I went to the
The other people we know.
Yeah. It's another
group that we are friends with. You know, it's like the boxing, the wrestling, the martial arts, the judo. I mean, we're all kind of the same family, so we all know each other from different things.
Yeah, yeah. It's a nucleus in like a continuum. We just keep doing the same job, seeing the same guys. Mm-hmm. And I remember, like, how many times did we see each other at auditions, right. me and you? Yeah, yeah. It was the whole shaved head crew over 40.
Oh, my God.
Remember the bad guys?
So many of them. And they all had dark beards.
I used to see you like every other day.
So I made my beard white. Do you remember Bob Wall?
Yeah. Yeah, the martial artist.
I ran into Bob last Saturday at a memorial for Jeff Everson. And when I got married years ago, he gave us $100 towards our wedding, which was really nice. Anyway, I asked him to come on my show. Now, Bob's got a long history of fighting.
Yeah.
He was a badass dude, too.
Yeah, yeah. And he did a great job in Into the Dragon.
Yeah, I know he did.
Yeah, he did a great job.
And he's a realtor and investment counselor down in Tarzana, and he's like runs around with Chuck Norris, and just a great guy.
Yeah, I was on Walker, Texas Ranger.
Were you?
I did the fourth last one, and I did, I was lucky enough to be on there with, Hulk Hogan.
Oh, yeah, Hogan. Yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah. They flew us down to Farmers Branch, Texas, and it was the fourth to the last episode ever.
You know where that came from? I was training at Northridge Golds, and Chuck was training there, and Hogan was training there, and all the other guys, and Brutus Beefcake, we all kind of trained together. And so Chuck said to Hogan, when are we going to work together? When are we going to work together? And I guess it probably came out that way.
And you know, they it was in Dallas, and they brought us to a place called Papa Do's. It was this big restaurant, and it had seafood enchiladas. Mm. I'm telling you, man, it's so good, you make you want to slap your mom. We went there, I hung out, I did a scene with Chuck and Hulk. It's probably my favorite scene ever. And yeah, they're both sweethearts.
Oh, yeah, my God, I mean, they're
great guys, man.
Chuck's a really good guy. I when I had hair, I had a headband on. Someone says, you look like Chuck Norris. And so I was at the gym one day, and he comes in. I said, Chuck, come here, man, I got to look at you really close. I said, someone said I look like you. And he says, well, you kind of do. I said, nah, I'm much better looking.
He, the thing I like about Chuck, you go on his set, it's all his family. Mm-hmm. And they're very Christian, they're very tight-knit, home-cooked meals. It's in Texas. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, it was great.
Yeah, he's definitely a good guy.
Class act.
So how do you train now? What do you do to keep your body in shape and be beat up?
I am at home. I kind of got into the cross fitness craze. You know, I got like the straps, the bands, mm-hmm. and then I got what this thing's called the power press push-up. And the funny part about it is I ordered it off Amazon. When I got it home, my friend was the model. And he does all the videos. So my friend Ian is on the box. So
really?
Oh, my God, yeah. It's funny as hell.
I think I was just on the phone with somebody saying, you know, you got to do something. You just can't sit home like he does and everybody else that I know and just watch TV all day and get fat. You got to exercise the body. It's like having your car sitting in the carport for a year. Everything gets stiff and there's no lubrication on the joints and you just got to keep it moving. Even through injury, I'm still going like you.
Yeah, if you get the like body elastics, the bands, and they sell a door anchor, it has 28 different anchors on it. Mm-hmm. You can do the band work, and then you can do the push-up work, mm-hmm. and then the TRX, you just hang on the roof, you hang off that, and you can do some crazy different move, one-on push-ups, you can pull up, you can hang upside down, so I do a lot of that at home, and when I go to the gym, I go to a great private gym, Moses Fitness. When I do go, it's amazing.
Where's this?
It's North Hollywood, I believe, Valley Village.
Oh, Valley Village. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's on Victory. Oh, it's amazing. It has cross fitness, and they also have weightlifting and powerlifting meets there, in-house. Hmm. So it's, the owners are amazing. They're four brothers. I love the place. It's like being home.
I haven't seen it, and I'm up that way a lot.
It's old school, like Key style gym back in the old days.
Yeah.
I mean, that they dare to do that.
Yeah.
And they've had no problems. They got all really good clients there.
That's the main thing if you do. Yeah. What's your plans for the future, other than to sit next to Rick Grayson?
Well, the Hall of Fame, putting a lot into that.
Yeah.
Inducting people, helping a lot of people. Bare knuckle fighting has become legal. They've legalized it again.
I heard that, yeah.
Yeah, so it was legal on Indian reservations, so now I'll get into the promotion part of it, and I'll probably train some fighters, you know? So I'll be like an old crusty bare knuckle Mickey.
Well, on Indian reservations, that must be pretty intense.
Intense? Pretty
you
intense.
You caught that, right? Well, I'm glad you came by. I know that you're a busy guy, but I just wanted to talk to you. I want to promote your show coming up. Is it open to the public?
No, the first one's closed, but the it'll be ongoing. We'll be inducting people
right.
constantly, so you'll be able to go in the future, and I'll be selling like gold memberships, stuff mm-hmm. like that. Yeah, this one, the first one was like an experimental thing to get it going.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's going pretty good, man. It's helped a lot of people, and I'm like a child. I'm so excited. Well, you know, it's coming up May 18th.
I know, I'm very excited to go.
I can't wait to see it. We got lady female wrestlers, we got female fighters, we got fighters from all kinds of nature, and then we got epic, legendary, bare knuckle fighters, and some really epic bodyguards that have just been around. One's even a mercenary.
Well, I wish you really good luck on this thing. I'll promote as much as I can, even though it's not open to the public, but get the word out there so people know it's going to be ongoing down the road.
Yeah, and I just wanted to say about Rick is that I never knew that you drew the Gold's Gym symbol.
It was just like doodling. You've known me forever.
I didn't know that. I'm like, and you play guitar?
I do.
And what don't you do?
Not much. No, I play guitar, I play keyboard, I do airbrushing. I used to do silk screening, I used to do a lot of tattooing.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, so you had a gun and stuff?
I have everything, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Until I started getting a bad element here, and women wanted me to do their crotch all the time. I was married, my wife didn't make a dinner. And I'm in the den, and she's looking at me, and I got this girl widespread with her crotch doing a tattoo on it. I said, what do we have?
Honey, it's dinner time.
Hopefully we're not having fish. So, I mean, I did stuff like that.
Oh,
then
Rick.
Then I taught wrestling out here for years. And, you know, it's just what it is. It's just what it is. I just wanted to have a life full of all the accomplishments I could put together and do them. And I did.
The Renaissance, man.
And I don't think I'm done yet. I mean, I hope I'm not.
So. No, it's you know what? It seems that it's done and we go, that's it. I'll never work again. And then something new happens.
Well, yeah, because you make your own luck. You make your own way in life. I'm not worried about getting hired for jobs. I don't need a job. And I don't want a job. I have my own job doing this show and doing my T-shirt designs and royalties and sponsors and working with other people like commercial stuff. And
you probably still get a little mailbox money from all the gigs you've done, right?
Oh, I had three royalty checks yesterday, one for $1.26, one for 18 cents, and one for $1.15.
My best one ever was one penny.
Oh, yeah.
And I put it on Facebook. Of course, I blocked out all my private information. And then every actor went, hey, Kevin, I got one for 3 cents.
It happens
I got
all
one
the
for
time.
6 cents.
All the time.
I get them all the
they
time.
They have to do that to keep their accounts straight. And so I don't cash them just to screw them up.
You know, I never do, too. It's kind of like, I think we all do this. You just throw them in a box.
I'm not going to go to the bank for $1.26.
I know. When they equal like 20 bucks and you got like 40 of them.
When they all add up and I get like 20 bucks, I'll cash it and that'll be lunch. That's stupid stuff. But it happens to everybody.
What, let me ask you this. What, so you got a penny before, right?
I've had low as a nickel.
Oh, what show was the nickel?
It could have been Charlie's Angels.
I did Charlie's Angels too.
I still get those. I had the Shield yesterday.
I get good ones from Charlie's Angels too.
I get some good, no, I get some good ones and I get some light ones.
Yeah.
And then I got the Shield and then I'll do Wild Wild West. I'll get a lot of those.
Wild Wild West?
Yeah.
Jesus.
And I'll go way back.
When was that? Like 70s?
1890. And then I'll do, I got Riptide and the Fall Guy. So
the Fall Guy? Lee Majors?
Yeah. Yeah.
The $6 million man. That's great.
Yeah. Yeah. That stuff comes in. Oh, well.
How many TV shows you think you've done?
Oh, my God.
Have you ever tried to tally it?
Let me put it this way. In order to retire from SAG with anything, you have to have 19 pension credits, and it takes a lot of work to get 19.
Ooh, yeah.
So I was able to retire at the age of 58 because I had a torn quad. So I got my retirement. I got a bundle of money, and then I get a monthly... what do you call it? A retirement check, and then I got full coverage insurance.
Wow!
So it's really good.
Producer's health plan. Yeah, mm-hmm. It's excellent.
Good health plan.
It's the best.
I go into my gynecologist at least once every 6 months.
There's a lot of openings in that.
There's
field.
A lot of openings in that field. And the only problem is that sometimes business has dried up a little bit.
I hope you don't get thrown off the air. Even
no,
though you're not
no,
on
no.
The
it's
air,
just,
right?
This is all true facts. What are you going to say? Yeah, I just tell people that I'm a vegetarian, and that's where I came from. Someone said, where were you born? I was born in West Virginia.
Tipping?
Yeah. It's just funny to be fun.
Yeah.
All right, thank you so much, Kevin.
Hey, thank you, everybody.
Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for more. I'll have more characters on like him. I don't know if there's any like him, but I'll have more on.
And support Rick's show.
See you
next
time.
Please support the Bare Knuckle and Bodyguard Hall of Fame.
Absolutely.
Thank you all.
Thank you guys. Bye-bye.
Hope you enjoyed the video brought to you by Old School Labs. Use my discount code DRAYSON12 on the link below at oldschoollabs.com.
Hey everyone, now you can have the Gold's Gym logo drawn by me, the artist Rick Drayson, personalized and made out to you and signed by me to frame and put on your gym wall or wherever you see fit to do so. It's a piece of bodybuilding history. It will never be duplicated again. It's the largest selling icon t-shirt logo in the world. And I'm the guy that drew it. And I will draw it for you. Just go to my website, rickdrayson.com, and order there. You can pay through PayPal, and it'll be sent out right away. And be sure to watch Rick's Corner for all the videos on bodybuilding, nutrition, fitness, pro wrestling, and anything that suits your interest as far as getting physically fit and being the best you can be from the golden era of bodybuilding.
Drayson. He's the equalizer, baby. See you next time.